And I'll be Zoon Andre back in our video today. This video is about Xavier Coates, you know, possibly making moves to the Melbourne Storm. So this is pretty big, I reckon, because Xavier Coates is obviously one of the best young talents in the NRL, and for him to make a possible move to the Melbourne Storm would be almost unfair, because Storm is stacked with talent and it always somehow finds talent from Queensland Cup, New South Wales Cup, whether it's, you know, even Holland Cup or whatever. Just Storm seem to find talent very easily and make an average player into a really good player, but Xavier Coates is no average player. He's an absolute star. Coates is just a really talented player. He's got a lot of upside to him. I think he's going to have a long, successful NRL future, Xavier Coates. And if Brisbane lose here, then Brisbane are in a world of pain, I reckon, because, you know, losing someone like him, who a good young kid they've produced for their like lower grades and all that, and to lose him would be pretty disappointing, I guess, because obviously he's a junior, I think, and losing him to a club like Storm, it's just gonna be difficult. Because another thing is, I feel like it's a good chance he will go to Storm, because Storm, obviously a big club. I know a lot of people hate him, including myself. I'm not a big Melbourne Storm supporter, but like, if he did come to Melbourne, I think Craig Bellamy and the rest of the Storm would probably make him a 10 times better player than he is right now. It'd be scary to think that they have Xavier Coates replacing Adokar, possibly, if he comes in 2022. That's if Coates does join the Storm in 2022 as a replacement for Adokar. Ramus is a replacement for Suliasi Vinivalu. Storm find it very easy to pick up talent, and I think if they get Xavier Coates and have Remus for one wing, I think they've replaced Suliasi Vinivalu and Josh Adokar pretty decently well. So, big sign that happened to the Storm, and I think it's a good chance. I understand yesterday, or maybe the day before, there was a picture saying of Xavier Coates with some Melbourne Storm or Wolves. So in the Gold Coast, I'll explain a bit more better. Xavier Coates was with a Melbourne Storm like member or something, or some sort of coach, and he was sitting with Craig Bellamy in the Gold Coast, Coates, and I think he was with his manager as well, and all discussing at a cafe somewhere, you know, about the possibility of, you know, Storm wanting Xavier Coates, and there's an actual picture of him talking to Bellamy, so it's interesting. And if Storm offer him, let's say Storm offer him about a good $1 million deal or something, I don't know about $1 million deal, but if they offer him a pretty decent deal that's pretty hard to knock back, then I think Coates is going to be heading to Melbourne, I reckon. I don't think that he would stay at Brisbane. I mean, I think he has a lot of mates at Brisbane, more than Melbourne, I think, because most of the Broncos team is probably played with, you know, because I think that, to be fair, the Broncos are mostly a bit of a, you know, young team with under 20s players and all that coming up. So I think Coates has more mates at Broncos. That could help him to stay. But, I mean, at Melbourne, obviously, you know, you have a lot of, obviously it's a very successful club. Obviously, you got a good coach in Craig Bellamy who gets the best out of his players no matter what. So if he gets a good deal by the Storm, it's really hard to knock back. And I can't even see him knocking it back. So I think it's a good chance Coates is on his way to the Storm, in my opinion. But we'll see what happens. But I'm just saying right now that if Storm offer him a really good deal, like a really good one, then I think he'll go there. I don't see him staying at the Broncos. If Broncos offer him a good deal as well, I just can't see him staying there, because he knows that the Broncos are a bit of a building stage with their team. I know they have a few good young players, you know, on the rise, a good crop of them. But I mean, if compare, look, I'm not trying to offend, you know, any Broncos fans watching. Like, I don't want to do that. But the thing is, Broncos just, they're a club that's building. They're not going to be good for a while, in my opinion. But in the future, they've got a great crop of young players, so that's something to look out for. But I just think that Storm are already ready. They're a champion-built club. They've got a lot of success. Obviously, they need a winger, and they're slowly replacing Adokar. I know they've got Lumi Loom and George Jennings, but they're probably just going to be back up at best. So I think getting Coates, so I think for Storm getting Coates, it would be absolutely scary. And I don't like comparing players to like certain legends of the game, like, but the thing is, I think Xavier Coates looks and plays a little bit similar to Greg Inglis when he was young at the Storm and all that. Because Greg Inglis was a young man, 20-year-old when he made his Australian Origin debut. And I think Xavier Coates is the exact same. And they look, and the funny thing is they look similar as well. And they just, yeah, there's a lot of comparisons between Xavier Coates and Greg Inglis. And look, just overall, if Storm get him, it's a brilliant signing. And it would be scary. Like, I sometimes think it's unfair that Storm can pick up this talent and make them, you know, into average players, into just somebody. Like, it's just a fantastic player. I mean, imagine having Justin Olam and Xavier Coates on one side. It's almost unstoppable. So, Coates, the Storm that happens, it's going to be absolutely really huge. And, it's going to be scary. If it was stuck for Brisbane, though, it's going to hurt Brisbane if they lose him, that's for sure. But, guys, that's the end of the video. Hopefully you enjoyed. Please like, comment, and subscribe to the channel. And what's your thoughts about the possibility of Xavier Coates going to the Storm? I think it's a good chance, so we'll wait and see what happens. But guys, hopefully you enjoyed, and this is probably my last video before Christmas. So guys, I just want to say Merry Christmas to you all, because I won't be doing a video tomorrow on Christmas Day. I'll be busy, but I hope you all have a great, lovely Christmas, and I can't wait to see, and I'll see you in the next video, guys. So have a great Christmas.